Breakfast Center halftime show. Railers up 24-12. Let's run down the first half scoring. Then running lead the way. Five, I think. Foul trouble in the first half. Five. Bryson Kirby, four. Nice game. Team Sloan, eight for two. And it was a holiday. One. Four jersey girls. They are next by three from Kurt Hall. And two from Andrew Shaw.
Coach Blakeman's going to have his kids ready and prepared, no doubt. He knows what we do year in, year out, and it's just a matter of Lincoln going out and executing their game plan on what they do. But, yeah, we've been making the trip down to Chatham next Friday.
And you have to believe that Glenwood may have a little revenge on their mind, because remember last year in the season finale, the Railers got the win and kept Glenwood from winning the outright conference championship.
Yeah, yeah, and, you know, we always play, I don't want to say always, but, you know, a majority of the time we go down there, you know, we play some of our best basketball just because that intensity's there, the aggressiveness, and I don't doubt it being anything but next Friday.
Railers have the ball to start the second half, and with it, Nolan Hollinger drains a three, Nolan's first three of the night, and the Railer lead is quickly up to 15 at 27-12.
Yeah, I'm sure Lincoln went in at halftime, made some halftime adjustments.
Down low, nice move, but they couldn't get the layup to go down as Ross missed an easy one. Rebound to Grunder, hands off to Cannon. Railers head the other way a minute into the third quarter, up by 15. Grunder, shot fake, nice drive on the baseline, off the glass, and good.
Grunder right to the rim, finished strong. And just like that, Lincoln up 17.
Biggest lead of the night for the Railers. Grunder now with 12. On the right side, three on the way from Whitman. Nope.
Where's the travel there?
Kick it back. That's no good. And Bryson with the rebound.
And now Coach Al's up off his seat. And he didn't. I mean, that looked worse than Sloan's.
Hollinger in the corner. And I think Coach is still talking about it.
Yeah, he is.
Nolan with the drive.
Get Sloan in there.
Goes down, and he's fouled, and he'll go to the line.
Nolan fighting bronchitis, didn't play a whole lot last night, and I'm sure that had something to do with it, but he came tonight ready to play. He's got some energy and just hit a three earlier, and now it goes to the basket. Strong makes the layup and going to the line for the and one.
Nolan with five all here in the first minute 47. Make it six, hits the free throw. 32-12, Lincoln has quickly built a 20-point lead.
The scoreboard must be wrong, huh? You got 31?
Well, they had 29. You had three. Hall.
Oh, there you go.
Hall kicked away, stolen by Titus. Bowers, Grunder, another move. Far side to Cannon. Nolan, another three. You betcha.
Hollinger feeling it tonight. Got him free in the corner for a three.
Welcome to the third quarter, also known as the Nolan Hollinger Show.
Yeah.
Nolan with nine.
There's a travel.
35-12, 5:24 to go. Timeout taken by Coach Reeder and Jerseyville. They're taking time. We'll take it with them. 5:24 to go in the third. Lincoln up big, 35-12. You're listening to Lincoln Railer Basketball. Railers with an 11-0 run to start the third quarter. And you know it's bad if the team that you're playing has gone on a run at the start of a quarter that's 1 point shy of what you've got so far for the game.
Yeah, and that we talked a little bit on break, Jeff, that they're concentrating, you know, on Bryson and Isaiah, and we're getting some guys wide open for some good looks, and Nolan's able to hit some, knock some down. He's got 9 points, and Grunder as well. He's got 12, so guys are stepping up, making some shots, and that's exactly what we need.
So after the turnover, Railers back in the front court. Grunder between the circle. Now over to Bryson Kirby. Hollinger hands back to Bowers. Back to Kirby. Right side to Grunder. Isaiah's open for three. It's on the way. Shot it up long. Rebound down to Whitman for the Panthers.
They keep switching defenses on us, Jeff. Now they're back in the zone. They were man-to-man.
Whitman has picked up his dribble. Double team from Cannon and Kirby. But he gets out of it to Hall. Hall skips it across the top of the zone. Now back over to Gibson. Ridenour. He'll fire a three top of the key on the way in. Good. Ridenour's first points of the night. 35-15.
Now we're looking at a 1-3-1. There's a little alley-oop to Grunder.
Lob, nice catch by Ben. Catches, goes down, comes up the other side, and lays it up and in.
Good job by Ben to go up and get it instead of trying putting it back. Regain his composure and go up for a nice easy layup.
Nearing the four-minute mark, Lincoln up 37-15. Ridenour hands back to Gibson. Gibson at the top of the key, back to Ridenour. Railers have done a better job against Ross down low as they did in the first half.
And
they had it. They got it to him. Tipped away by Isaiah. Isaiah ahead of everybody. The finger roll layup is good.
Good job by Isaiah forcing the turnover and got rewarded with the pass for a nice, easy fingertip layup.
39-15. Ridenour hands to Ross. Ross dumps it down. Shot's going to be missed. Grunder tips the rebound out into the hands of Cannon. Titus looks ahead. Ahead to Bryson. Bryson kicks back over to Nolan. On the wing, steps back. Three on the way, short. Rebound to Isaiah, puts it back up. That won't go. Fight for the rebound. Isaiah comes out with it at the free throw line.
Good job by Lincoln, getting a second chance there.
3:15 to go in the third. Bryson from near the volleyball line, off to the right side, no good. Rebound to Hall.
Stop the ball. They're going to get Bryson with the foul. Being a little lazy right there. Or a little tired, one or the other. Maybe both.
Bryson.
Oh, they get Cannon with it.
They got Titus with it.
They were both being lazy.
See, Bryson's like, I didn't do it. See, I was there.
I'd have gave it to Bryson.
3:03 to go, 39-15. Lincoln up 24. Jerseyville looking to inbound. Goldacker. Tried to throw it in. The ball's tipped away. Ball loose, but it's Shaw that comes up with a nice bullet pass underneath.
Oh, there's a foul not called. Oh, my
glass,
God.
Nothing called. Nolan grabbed him right across the wrist.
Yeah, he did.
I think that's the – it's a 24-point game. We're not going to call it play. But still.
That kid came out of there like, I mean, what's going on here?
And then that's called as Isaiah got a little bump as he tried to drive the lane.
Well, you miss some.
Foul for Jerseyville at the 2:42 mark.
And
we've got. Do we have blood?
Well, yeah, I think so. Or maybe said something. Well, there's no technical.
And I don't see him making any movement toward getting it cleaned off or changing jerseys or anything. So
maybe.
The inbound pass from Kirby trying to get it to Cannon. Stepping in front of it was Sauerwin for the steal. Over to Shaw. Watched by Hollinger. Bounce down low. Hard to catch him when they throw it at your ankles.
Yeah, that was a horrible pass.
Again, and a foul is going to be called as Cannon and Hollinger were both there.
And they're going to get Nolan.
Fowler Nolan, that'll be his second on the Railers in the half.
He's shaking his head. Well, you know, why did you call that one and not the one that I almost ripped his arm off?
2:28 to go in the third. And they're calling Bryson over with one of the officials to the bench. And Bryson's going to the end of the bench, so I wonder, it's almost like he pointed at Bryson's face, so I don't know if Bryson's got something on his face for blood or something like that, but they're going to have to get that cleaned off before Bryson can come back in. Three is going to rattle around, rest on the back of the rim, and then fall for Ridenour, his second three, and that makes it 39-18, Railers up 21. 2:10 to go. Morrison for Bryson. Bowers with a move in the lane. Goes against four Panthers. Didn't get it to fall.
Yeah, that's one you want to see him kick it out. You know, he's got four guys in front of him. He had two guys wide open on the perimeter.
And then travel called.
But you like seeing Bowers being aggressive. He's kind of lost that the past few games where he hasn't really been getting to the rim and maybe forcing some outside shots. But he's too good of a basketball player, and he's a little bit of a funk right now, which, you know, everybody goes through, but he'll come out of it.
Nice cut.
And that right
Isaiah.
There will do it. You know, get him doing those back cuts for nice, easy layups, and then that's going to open up his outside game.
Titus found him on the back door. Isaiah laid it up and in. Isaiah now with nine. 41-18, Railers up by 23. Ridenour tried to hand it off to Hall, and that bullet pass to someone who's standing about 8 inches away is usually never going to happen in a good way. We look down at the end of the bench, and Bryson,
got
I guess.
Blood all over him.
Hollinger, as we tick down toward a minute, down in the corner to Bowers, back to Zach Morris. Morris kicks it over on the left side to Grunder. We hit the 1 minute mark, third quarter, Lincoln up 23. Hollinger far side to Titus. Titus skips it all the way over to Morris. Isaiah, 15 footer, no, he tried to dump it down to Morris and did. Grunder from the right wing for three, left it way short. Isaiah tracks it down.
Let's pull it back out, hole for one.
Down to 40 seconds. Now the Railers look to hold for that final shot. Bryson all taken care of. Under 30 seconds, Railers up 23.
Coach, you have to do some extra scrubbing on that jersey tonight. Get all the blood out of there.
Zach's picked up his dribble, needs some help. Gets it back out to Hollinger. Isaiah at the timeline. Down to 13. Grunder, we're down to 8, gotta go. Grunder, down the lane, kick back out. Hollinger, can he end the quarter in fashion?
Yes, he can
for three.
Nolan Hollinger with 12.
Fitting it was Nolan who ended the third with a three. 44-18, Railers up 26. We'll start the fourth in a moment. You're listening to Lincoln Railer Basketball. Ones for the Railers. Joined now by Coach Neil Alexander. Coach, congratulations on the win. Gave up the last 16 of the game, but I guess when you're up by 36, you'll take that. A good performance, but I know you're always looking for that four quarters, and when you've got some of the kids out there that don't get as much game time, that's sometimes a little bit harder to judge, but when the regulars were in there, pretty good performance tonight from the Railers.
Yeah, I thought the first half we missed some layups. I think we missed 8 and missed some free throws. You know, two things that's the easiest or should be the highest percentage shots in basketball, I think, are the lowest for us. So, but we come out with some intensity and attack the way we should and had a good third quarter.
Coach, we've seen glimpses of what Ben Grunder can do. We saw that last year, and we saw it here tonight where Ben is certainly a threat from both outside, but it seems like he really helps the team the most when he's able to take it from the outside and drive to the basket and make things happen.
Well, he makes defense honor that, and you know, we need to be able to get to the basket, and that's really the strong point of his game. And you know, and then, you know, if you don't want to cover him, you lay off of him. He's capable of hitting a three. So Ben had a good game. Ben had a good weekend, and you know, those are good things. And you know, with developing some depth, and you know, we'll see where we're at when everybody gets healthy again.
Coach, you talk about having a good weekend. Of course, the Railers fell to Lanphier on Tuesday, but Springfield and Jerseyville may have fallen on the schedule exactly when this Railer team needed it to fall.
No doubt. You know, we went to Collinsville, and we, you know, the teams, we didn't play very well, and that's what I think the years that we've been going to Collinsville, that might have been our worst performance down there. And usually we go down there and, you know, perform pretty well. I thought last year we performed the first two games pretty well, and then we kind of laid an egg the last two. But, you know, you are playing very good competition when you go down there, and you try to teach your kids to make sure that you're staying on top of things. And, you know, tonight was one of those games that you play the same way, whether you're up 30, down 30, tied, close ball game. You learn to play the same way, and that means guard the people and run your offense, execute, and do the things that we do to make us successful.
Coach, one of the players who's been bitten by the sickness bug, hopefully getting a little better. At least he was better in the third quarter. Nolan Hollinger had a really nice quarter for you there.
Well, you know, when they start taking away the help, they had two guys, basically, they were playing a helping three-man defense and keeping the ball from Bryson and Isaiah, and then Nolan stepped up, and that's what you got to have. You got to have people who can step up when people are playing those junk defenses, and that's why they play junk defenses, to see if someone else can hit shots, and that was big tonight.
Coach, we heard you this morning on the Cheap Seats talk a little bit about Jermaine Hamlin. Jermaine got his first varsity action here tonight. And we know that he's only been playing basketball, what now, for a couple years. I guess it's really hard to gauge. You can see him in practice, but until he gets into game situations, even though it's late in the game, that game speed, I think, is probably the thing that's going to be the most challenging.
Well, at the varsity level, right. You know, that is a game speed. And, you know, he's got to grow into the body. That's just the way it goes. And I'm hoping it happens before he leaves here. But for someday, he's going to be a really, really a good player.
Coach, no game middle of the week this week, but starting on Friday, it's what Scott and I were calling here tonight, the longest named tournament that the Railers have played in, the Central State 8 non-city boys basketball tournament. Start at Friday night down in Chatham against the Glenwood Titans. They've had a struggle this year, but starting to turn things around, and with Coach Blakeman, he's going to find a way to play as well as he can with the pieces he has.
Oh, no doubt. You know, he does a great job with the kids. They're young. As the year goes on, they're only going to get better, and he's got it in the back of his mind what's going to happen here in the next two or three years, because they're really going to be good. And, you know, we got to go down there with a mindset that, you know, they're playing three freshmen, and they may be in starting three. And those kids can play a little bit, and we just have to be able to go down there and take care of business. And, you know, used to, by playing in the, used to be the Meyer Classic down
right.
there, we got to be where that was almost like a home court to us, to where we played very well down there. We played very well last year, so... That's a fun place to go. It's you know, I think there's a pretty good rivalry, and I think that that's a school that could remain on our schedule for a non-conference game.
And that's one of the things I was going to ask. I heard you talk this morning about, you know, trying to want to keep some of the conference rivalries open, but, you know, the Springfield schools, it's difficult because they've only got the one non-conference opening, but I think there's a lot of folks that you see Lincoln and Glenwood on the marquee. That's a game you want to see no matter what season either team is having.
Oh, yeah. You know, it's one that we will it's a good game. Mm-hmm. The problem is it's a good game, and it's like 28-27.
Yeah, first to 30 wins at that.
Yeah, and, you know, but we done some things to him last year that helped us out. Again, it's a chess match. He'll watch a lot of tape of last year's game and make adjustments on what we did, and it'll be a chess match. So we got to be able to have some counters for how we're going to play him and so forth. But that'll be a big game for us to go down there, and hopefully we can pick that one up.
And, of course, right back here a week from tonight, the tournament continues. I believe it's MacArthur that comes in a week from tonight.
Yeah, you know, we play the way it goes is we've got Chatham, then we got MacArthur next Saturday, then we go to Rochester on Tuesday, which Rochester plays very well at home, mm-hmm. and they're playing everybody close but just can't get over the hump. And they've got kids that are, you know, here we are January, they're starting to be in practice for 4 weeks and 5 weeks, and they're starting to get back to a little bit of basketball, so that would be a tough one. Then we got Jacksonville at home, and then we have to go play Eisenhower at Rochester for the final night. So we would like to be pretty good this next week and a half and come away and win this for the last time.
And, Coach, final thing, we know that you've always talked about the way the conference ends up. Usually, for the Railers, how you play in that, when it was the Meyer Classic or now this tournament, when you've got those five conference games packed into a week plus, you can really gain some ground or you can lose some ground pretty quickly.
Real quick. You know, so, you know, it's important. And we've talked to kids, and, you know, if you want any chance to stay in the conference race, we have to take the games one at a time. Mm-hmm. We got to play Friday night. And you can't worry about Saturday, Tuesday, or whatever, or be even thinking about it. You have to be focused on Friday night at Chatham. And if we can do that, then hopefully good things will happen for us. And you try to get them ready to play every night now. And, you know, here in after the tournament's over, we don't have but a handful of games left.
Right.
I mean, you get through the tournament. This year is just about over. You'll be thinking about seeding for the regional, and you'll go from there.
All right, Coach, we'll let you go after this one. A good weekend for the Railers. A win last night down in Springfield. Come back home and get the win here against Jerseyville, and you kept your promise. It was nice and warm in here tonight.
Well, I haven't even broke a sweat. Really, I haven't. I'm pretty calm, but I'd rather be in here than outside.
I don't blame you.
It's cold out.
All right, Coach, we'll let you go, and we'll see you Friday night down in Chatham.
Okay.
Railers get the win, 57-37. We'll wrap it up in a moment. You're listening to Lincoln Railer Basketball.
Lincoln Railer Basketball on WLCN 96.3 and streaming live at WLCNonline.com is brought to you by Shelter Insurance Agent Corey Leonard, AAA Window Siding and Doors, The Carpet House, Lincoln Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, Lincoln IGA, Fifth Street Food Mart, Timbercrest Veterinary Service, the Lincoln Park District, Rick Ham State Farm Insurance, Lincoln Heating and Cooling, Lincoln Printers, Memorial Sports Care at Abraham Lincoln Memorial Hospital, Lincoln College, Stacy's Family Pharmacy, Community Action Partnership of Central Illinois, Grau Incorporated, Schneider Chiropractic, St. Clara's Manor, Eaton Corporation, Jim Examus Ford Lincoln, Bright Ideas Screen Printing and Embroidery, Headline Salon LLC, Citizens to Elect Kevin Bateman for Lincoln Mayor, Family Custom Cleaners, Laundry, Tanning and U-Haul, Denise Costello Salon at 416 Holly Drive, Gary's Drywall, Finishing, Painting and Power Washing, Connect Construction, Lincoln Dare, AG Farms, and by Stuffed Area Pizza,